and gentlemen, welcome to the Canaway. I'm Adil, and this here is the all new Retro TV video game sent over by our friends at PloyLab. For your very own, be sure to check out the link in the description.
Below.
That's right, so this is the Bookshelf Retro TV.
The GV300, a miniature video game system consisting of 108 NES games.
The box itself, pretty standard looking box here, very small. I don't know if you can tell, but this thing is tiny. On top it says Bookshelf Retro TV. I'm gonna assume that's a typo. So it's Bookshelf Retro TV. It's a clock plus wireless gaming, so perfect for your desktop, bookshelf, what have you. And then on the front, you got the two controllers that it comes with, as well as the screen, the little computer, the little gaming system right here. So this is the Family Pocket Retro TV. On the back here, it shows you what is included. You got the Retro TV, the manual, batteries, AV cable, charger cable, and double wireless pad. So you do get two controllers with this. All right, so let's go ahead and open this up and see what is inside. You wanna do it?
Yeah.
All right. There you go. Hey, it's like a smiley face. What is this? Why does it look like a smiley face? Controller one. Let's see. You get a little smiley face on it. That's what I'm talking about. Okay, so this is a very tiny, thin controller. I don't know how it's going to be to hold it, but you know what? It'll do the trick, I'm pretty sure. So that's controller one. Let's get the second controller out. Same exact thing. All right. So this is the controller right here. Kind of reminds me of the old Super Nintendo controllers. You got the D-pad, the joystick on this side. And then four buttons here, X, Y, and Y, X upside down. Menu select start, and then two buttons on top with a micro USB charger in the middle. And off to the back, you got the battery right here as well. And then you can switch between player one and two, just like that. So yeah, this is the controller.
All right, so let's take out the rest of this stuff. Oh, this is the little TV. Look how tiny this thing is. Very unique, very different. I don't think I've ever seen anything like this before.
TV.
You got a fake antenna that you could put on top to give it a little bit more realism to make it look retro. So let's put that on as well. There you go. What else we got? We got a instruction manual. That's right. Shows you how to use it. So what we do know is there's 108 Nintendo Entertainment System video games on here. So that's really cool because I'm a huge classic NES fan, so it's nice to get nostalgia back up in here. So we're gonna check those out very quickly. Oh yeah, the cool thing about this is you can connect this to a larger TV. So if this screen is too little for you, yeah, this connects to a bigger TV and you can play your video game on your bigger screen. All right, check this out, guys. That looks cool, right? What do you think? You like this?
Yeah!
Yeah! So this is it. This is your handheld video game. Not only that, you can obviously see it's also a desktop clock with the date. Now you can change the colors on that if you'd like. It's defaulted to red, so that's what you see. Now, at first glance, this thing is extremely tiny and lightweight. Now, if you look at the controller next to it, the controller is actually a little bit bigger, so to speak. So yeah, this is it. It's got a cool retro look to it, old school style TV. Kind of like it, I'm digging it. To go over a few of the buttons, let's go over those really quickly. You got three buttons on the front right here, your left, your set, your right button. To set up the contrast, the color, and what have you. You got the link and power button, which are pin buttons that you can go ahead and use. You got two dials on top here. The top one is fake, it does nothing. Bottom one is your power button and your volume control. Off to the side, you got your USB power and your AV out, audio visual. To the back, that's where your rechargeable battery goes. And to the other side, you got your system reset. So yeah, this is pretty much it. Now this color is gray. They come in two different colors. You can also get this in yellow, but we went with the gray one right here. So let's go ahead and turn this on and show you guys what it's all about. All right, 108 in one. So that's how many games are on here. So let's go ahead and quickly glance over what we got. Okay, now that I'm noticing this, Mario 16. Not sure why it's going all the way to number 16, but I guess there's some games that I must have missed out on back in the day. Turtles, Ninja Turtles, I'm assuming, Adventure Island, Shadow Warriors, Gaiden? I'm not sure what that is either. Hot Blood. A lot of multiple games with different series. Tiny Toon, Chip Dale, Street Fighter, Batman. A lot of games that I hadn't heard of. But we'll go ahead and click a few of these just to see what it's all about. Yep, so that's all of them right there. So let's go ahead and try something out. Let's check out Super Mario Brothers, because that's always a classic, and let's see if it's the original. All right, there you go.
It does have a built-in speaker. Not sure if it's one of the best.
It works just good. Perfectly fine. I'm just trying to see how it runs. Not this bad, guys.
Yeah, it runs really smooth. No lag whatsoever.
There you go. So it actually runs pretty smooth. Now, to get to the main menu, just press the menu button on your controller right here. It goes back to the defaulted screen. I was kind of about 2-3 feet away from the screen, and it's working just fine all wirelessly. So this is great. Let's try another game. Yeah, I was curious to know what Super Mario 16 is, so let's click that. From 93, okay. Yeah, no, I don't think I've ever played this. Oh yeah, I don't know what this is. So that is Mario 16. Let's check out a couple more games here. Ninja Turtles was always fun. Let's try that out, see what it's all about. The best turtle out there, Raphael. I vaguely remember this. Now, it does come with 2 controllers, so if you got someone else with you, you can also play 2 players on games like this. Yep, so you get the point. Now, if you look at the screen, it's actually not that bad. The quality is not 100%, but it's not too bad either. So this is what you get. Let's try one more game out, something that I haven't heard of. Rockman 3. Oh no, I think I've heard of this, maybe. Alright. I just noticed, like, all the games are very similar. They all kind of, you know, the same theme going on. I wonder if that's intentional. Yeah, just to give you an idea. So yeah, that's pretty much what it is.
Well, there you folks have it, the Bookshelf Retro TV by Ploy Lab. Now, if you guys have any questions, be sure to put them in the comments below. Other than that, thanks for watching, guys.
Bye-bye.